Hello, this is Ryan Roye from Liberty3D.com. Let's take a look at a few things that are hard or impossible to do in native Lightwave. How about animating this notoriously dense DAZ3D character head with no endomorphs, no rig, and no controllers? Or blending between two entirely different rigs that perform two entirely different functions without a performance hit or complicated constraint system? Or cartoon animations, or isolating dynamics to just parts of your one-layer character mesh, or performing modeling operations in layout. Actually, there's a lot of things that are hard to do natively in Lightwave, and that's why we have the Third Powers Cage and Lattice tools, which have made a significant impact to the way I approach animation in Lightwave. So much so that I've decided to create training content that focuses exclusively on the topic of animating and rigging with these third-party tools. I present to you Cage and Lattice workflows with Third Powers. The content, of course, starts with the basics, telling you everything that's required to get off the ground and how these tools function at their most basic level. Then we jump right into the more advanced concepts like rigging and combining cages and lattices with Lightwave's existing toolset. In the interest of getting people up to speed with these brand new tools as quickly as possible, this training content is not designed for beginners, and it assumes that you have at least general knowledge of Lightwave layout and modeler. In other words, I've worked very hard to make sure that your time spent watching this content is highly focused, productive, and efficient. And know that all of my commercial tutorials are scripted and carefully reviewed before publication. If you want to get the very most out of the Third Powers layout tools and take your rigging and animation workflows to a new level, pick up a copy of Cage and Lattice Workflows at Liberty3D.com.